Hello friends, my name is Tushar and today I'm going to talk about how to find a cycle in an undirected graph. So here I have a graph and this graph contains a cycle. So this graph should say that yes, I contain a cycle. If I remove this edge here, then this graph doesn't contain a cycle anymore. So it should say that I do not contain a cycle. So there are many ways to find a cycle in an undirected graph, like using disjoint sets, using DFS, using topological sort and a few other ways. In today's video, I'm going to talk about a couple of these techniques. One is using disjoint sets, another is using DFS to find a cycle in an undirected graph. Let's first talk about how to find a cycle in an undirected graph using disjoint sets. In another video, I talked about how disjoint sets work, and if you have not watched that video, I highly recommend you watching that video before continuing on this video. So if you remember, disjoint set supports three operations: make set, union, and find set. Let's see how we're going to use disjoint sets to find a cycle in an undirected graph. So the idea is very simple. All you have to do is create as many sets as the number of vertices you have, and then you have to pick an edge, and you have to see both the ends of both the vertices of this edge are in the same set or in different set. If they're in a different set, then you have to union those two sets together, and if they're in the same set, it means that so there is another edge which unites them together. So this edge must be creating a cycle in the graph. So let's work with this example. So first I do is I call a make set on all these six vertices. So I have A, B, C, D, F, E, D. So here I have six sets. So then I pick any edge. So let's say I picked this edge. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a find set on A that is going to return me A, and then I'm going to do a find set on F and that is going to return me F. At this point, both A and F are not in the same set. It means that adding this edge is not going to create a cycle. Then what we do is we do a union of these two sets. So then they are together now. So we will have A, F, and a union. So they are now in the same set. And let's say the set is represented by A. Now let's pick another edge. So let's say we picked edge ED. Again, we do a find set on E that returns me E, and then I do a find set on D and that returns me D. And again, they are in the different set. So again, adding this edge is not going to create a cycle. So let's first do, and then let's do a union of these two sets. Alright, let's pick another edge. Let's say we picked edge CD. So we do a find set on D. Let's say this set is represented by E. So I do a find set on D, so that returns me E, and then do a find set on C, and that returns me C. So again, this set and this set are different. Again, so adding this edge is not going to create a cycle, so let's union them. So something like this, and again we say that E represents this entire set. So next, let's pick this edge. A is represented by A and B is represented by B. Again, they are in two different sets, so adding this edge is not going to create a cycle. Let's union these two sets. All right. Let's add edge BE. So B is represented by A, so find set on B returns A, and find set on E returns E. So A and E are in two different sets right now. So again, this edge is not going to create a cycle. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a union of these two sets. So we'll have something like this. And let's say E represents my entire set. So finally, let's add this edge BC. So what will happen is B is represented by E. When we do a find set on B, we get E. When we do a find set on C, we again get E. What that means is that both these guys are already in the same set. It means that there must be another way to connect B to C, and that edge is not this edge. So by adding this edge, it means that you are going to create a cycle in the graph. So this edge here creates a cycle in the graph, and that's how we find out that there is a cycle in a graph using disjoint sets. In the next section, let's talk about how we find cycle in undirected graph using DFS algorithm. So in DFS, we'll keep a visited set to know which vertices we have already visited. So we can start from any vertex. Let's say we start from A. So first thing we do is we put A in the visited set. Then we explore the neighbors of A. Let's say we have explored F first. So we go in the direction of F, and we also pass A to F, saying that I'm coming from A. And then F is going to explore its neighbor. So the first neighbor it's going to find is A. And since it's coming from in the direction of A, there is no reason to continue in that way direction. And then F has no other neighbors. So we also visited F. And then F goes back to A. And then A explores its other neighbor, which is B. And again, it passes A to that neighbor. So again, first thing we do is we put B into the visited set. Then B explores its neighbors. So the first neighbor it encounters is A. And since it is already coming from A, because we passed A to B, it knows that it doesn't need to go in that direction. So then it explores another neighbor. So let's say that neighbor was C. And C is not in the visited set. It means that it can go in the direction of C. So we go from B to C. And we pass B to C, saying that this is where you're coming from, and we'll also put C in the visited set. C will repeat the same process. C will explore its neighbor. So first neighbor it sees is B, and it knows that it's already coming from B, so there is no reason to go in that direction. So C explores its other neighbor, which is D. So we go from C to D and pass C to it and put D in the visited set. Then D will repeat the process. So D will not go in the direction of C. So D will explore E, and we'll put E into the visited set. And then E will not go in the direction of D. So what E is going to do is going to try to go in the direction of B. But what happened here is that B is already in a visited set. What that means was there must be another way to reach B from E, which is this way. So adding this particular edge is going to create a cycle in the graph. So this is how we know that there is a cycle in the undirected graph. Remember, it's an undirected graph, so all we need to do is maintain a visited set, and then we do a DFS and we pass the parent so that you know that you don't have to explore in that direction. And other than that, if you find any node which is already, if you find any vertex which is already in a visited set, it means that you found a cycle in the undirected graph. So in the next section, let's look at the code. So let's look at the code to find cycle in undirected graph using disjoint sets. So I have a very simple graph here, and I'm going to run through this code using this graph as an example. So first thing we do is we create an object of disjoint set. Then I iterate through all the vertexes of this graph and create that many sets. So I end up creating like four sets, A, B, C, D. Then I pick one edge at a time. So let's say we picked an edge AC. So I find the representative of A, edge, one vertex of this edge, and that is A. And then I find the representative two of the other vertex of this edge, and that's C. So A and C are not same. So what we do is we union A and C. So A and C are now together. And let's say they are represented by A. Then we go back to the top of this for loop. Let's pick another edge, say BC. So what we do is we find the representative, let's say B1 is B. So we find representative of B, and that's B. And we find representative of C, and that's A. So again, A and B are different. So we don't go into this if condition. We come here and we union these two guys together. Let's say A continues to be the representative of this set. Let's pick another edge, say CD. So we go back to the top of the for loop. We pick edge CD. We find the representative of C, that's A. And then we find the representative 2 of D, and that's D. Again, we don't go into this if condition, so we union this set and this set. So we end up having something like this. Now we go back to our top of the for loop and find edge AB. So we find representative of A, and that's A, and then we find representative of B, and that's also A. So in this case, representative 1 is equal to representative 2. So what we do is we instantly return true, saying that there is a cycle in this graph. So basically this, adding this edge is going to create a cycle in this graph. Let's analyze the space and time complexity. So space complexity is pretty simple. It's the total number of vertex, so that is O of V. Let's analyze time complexity. So this for loop here is going to take O of V time. Then, if you remember, from disjoint sets, if the total number of operations are n, and if the total number of elements in the disjoint sets is n, and if m is greater than or equal to n, the amortized time for m operation is going to be O of m. In this case, our total number of elements in this set is going to be n, which is O of v. And the total number of operations is also going to be equal to v, because a number of edges we need to look is at max is going to be v, because as soon as we find the vth edge, as soon as, if the total number of vertices are v, as soon as we explore the vth number of edge, what will happen is that edge is going to create a cycle in this graph. So this for loop at max executes v times, and so the total number of operations is going to be, since we are doing find set multiple times and union one, so this total number of operations is going to be 3 of m. So in the worst case, the time complexity for this algorithm is going to be O of v. The time complexity for DFS algorithm is also going to be O of v, where v is the number of vertices, and the space complexity for DFS algorithm is going to be O of v. So this is all I have to talk about finding cycle in undirected graph. The link to the code is in the description section of the video. Please like this video, share this video, comment on this video, check out my GitHub page and my Facebook page. Thanks again for watching this video.